we went 3-7. So we was the livestock of the county. Like they like, oh, they back to the old old galley, this and that. But this year is gonna be way different. My name is Robert Stafford. I play cornerback and Robert Stephen for Galley High School.
All right, we got to start sending the message right now. But look, we talk all the time about when you beat people and the teams that win. And it's not always the strongest team. It's not the most well-coached team. It's not the fastest team. What is it?
Toughest. Well, I grew up in Melbourne, Florida. You know, it was it was hard at times, you feel me? It's still hard now. So, like I said in one of my videos, like, I ain't gonna stop going until I get my mom out of the house. When I was five or six, I played up. I always played up. I played with the older people, so I was not in my age group. I played against the older people, so I used to kill them. So when it came to my junior and senior season, when everybody left, I can stay another 2 years on senior. So I stayed in, yeah. But my age group, it wasn't even fun. I ain't gonna lie.
Go,
go, go. When I first came in, I didn't even want to play corner for real. Like, they was telling me like I got the build and everything for it, but I was like hitting the end zone, you feel me? And then I started playing corner. It was like natural, like everything about it. Getting pitched, jumping high, because I played basketball too, so that helped with it. When I was little, I always wanted to go to college and play ball and go to the league. So right now, I accomplished one of my goals and I committed, you feel me? So it still ain't hit me yet either, I ain't gonna lie. But yeah, like the recruitment process, it was stressful too at times, I'm not gonna lie. Like we had issues, you know, family, like trying to tell me what they think I should do, people who wasn't there. You know what I mean? Like, so I just kept the people in my circle, in my household, or like people I really trusted. I asked them their opinions and stuff like that, but the decision came up to me. But for some people, you know, you ain't gonna make everybody happy. So it's always like that. That's life.
I'm finna get loud tonight, man.
Everybody was saying I didn't deserve what I got. My freshman and sophomore year, like all the time, they would just be like, I don't deserve what I got. So like, I always had a chip on my shoulder since my freshman year. Like, and they had me believing it too. You know, I had to like learn how to like not listen to them boys or everybody else, even grown people.
Yeah, so with all that being said, I like to take my talents to the University of Miami.
Woo! My dream school was Oregon. Like it was hard to not go there because everything was coming apart. Like the coaching staff was liking me, you know, everything felt right there and everything. So it was a real hard decision between Miami and Oregon. And I just picked Miami because it was home. Like it's a real family over there. Like this, it's genuine over there. Like the U, you feel me? Like everybody know it's a dynasty over there. So why like lead the state if you ain't got to lead the state of Florida? Like
in Brevard County alone, there's been 4 selected as Under Armour All Americans, 5 that played the game. This is the first one out of Gallup. We're extremely excited for Robert and this opportunity. Robert Stafford, congratulations on achieving your dreams and becoming an Under Armour All-American. We look forward to seeing you in Orlando on January 3rd. Robert Stafford, 2023 Under Armour All-American.
I became All-American by, like, the offers helped. I ain't gonna lie, like, the offers helped, but the people that was at the camp, like, I had the fastest 40 time. I had the highest, I think it was like vertical jump. Yeah, I had the highest vertical jump and I had the fastest L drill. So I did all that, like, you feel me? I performed, like, so that's how I became that. But the offers helped me get into the camp, but you gotta perform and make the game inside the camp, you feel me? So I performed in there, and then I always went to the All-American game when I was a little kid too, so I always wanted to make it. And then when I made it, that was a dream come true too. So everything coming in part, but I know everything ain't perfect either, so I had to work for that, for real.
Coach, you about to go viral.
Think he gonna look different? Coach know he ugly, man. Coach know he ugly, cuz. Hey, Coach, just don't cut the beard. Don't cut the beard. Man, you tripping, boy. I ain't gonna lie, I wanna be the best player to ever leave O'Galley. I don't even think I told Coach Sands that before, but I'm a like that's one of my goals, which is that. But the biggest goal, like, is to win a state championship. That's the biggest goal. I'll take that over anything.
Ain't nobody gonna take it easy on you here if you haven't noticed that yet. I don't want Coach to make you feel good when it's time to come out and throw 7-on-7. I want you to feel like shit. So when we go on Friday, we ready to roll and we ain't backing down to nobody. Do we got that?
Yes, sir.
Take pride in what you do.
Last year, like, we got a lot of, like, we got a big chip on our shoulder. Like, we was the last stock of the county because we came off of a 9-2 season, my freshman year, I think it was. And then the next year, we went even, like, fifth round in the playoffs versus the American Heritage. I almost went to state and we lost. But, and then the next year when all them boys left, it's my junior year now, we went 3-7. So we was the last stock of the county. Like, they back to the old O'Galley, this and that. But this year it's gonna be way different. We gonna be back for sure.
EG on top.
Put me in there.
Most hated in the county. Yeah, we out on game.